Democrats and progressives running for office for cities, the counties, the states, the federal representation must fight on their terms. They must not allow Trump and the Republicans to dictate the narrative. It is not about socialism versus capitalism. Let's not fall for the con. Let me tell you what it's about. Tell the American people what it will mean to elect them into office. Be specific and tell them how you will do it. Progressives must stay on the offensive. Let conservative politicians defend the tax cut scam. Let them defend the tariffs. Let them defend the environmental destruction. Let them defend the world political turmoil. Do not at any time allow them to force you on the defensive, because it's the policies since Ronald Reagan for which we have the results of now that need defending. We are seeing the results of Reaganomics. We are seeing the results of voodoo economics as stated by George Herbert Walker Bush. We are seeing the effects of trickle-down economics. We are seeing the effect of supply-side economics. That is what we're seeing today. All the distortion within the markets, all the transfer of wealth from the people to the few, that is the result of Reaganomics. That is the result, the ultimate result to capitalism on steroids. Don't even argue about it anymore. That is what we have been living in under, and we must force them to defend that. We are not on the defensive here. So when Donald Trump says socialism, you say fair and moral economy requires that we do Medicare for all. Fair and just economy requires that we do family leave. Fair and just economy requires that we pay off student debt that is really a loan to corporations who need an educated supply of people, and they're trying to get it on the cheap. As states cut budgets, remember this, people have had to pick up on the price of education, both more tax dollars elsewhere as well as people themselves. So in effect, the raw material that these corporations need, as opposed to investing themselves in it, they believe in socialism for corporations. And how is the socialism for corporations? Because you are paying to educate the people that they must have. If they want to build a car, shouldn't they educate those people who are going to build the car, and then the profits then can be spent or let out equitably? No, that's not what they want. They want you to invest in everything that they need from you, but they have you believing that they are doing you a favor. They are doing you absolutely no favor. That capitalist sitting down at his pool, collecting on the appreciation of the stocks and the dividends of the stock, sitting down while you work, that is his income. That is his wealth. Your work. Let's make sure during the 2020 elections not to bite your tongues, not to go back there and retract, not to sit back there and feel like you're asking for something or begging for something. You are not. You're taking back what is yours. You're taking back what was stolen, because your politicians have been bought for so long. They have legally created structures to literally rob you. Let's get the narrative straight. They must defend it. When they talk about tariffs to allow folks to make more product in America, a tariff isn't a penalty on the country selling stuff to you. How do you think Donald Trump is helping to not make his budget explode more than it's exploding right now? Tariffs. And what are tariffs? Taxes that, guess who pay? You do. You pay the tariffs. When they charge a tariff on aluminum, you pay a higher price in car. And that higher price is a tax that then goes into the treasury. And when that goes into the treasury, that offsets that tax cut scam that went to the rich people. Folks, I need you to understand exactly how things work in this country. And that is why I wrote the book, As I See It, Class Warfare, The Only Resort to Right-Wing Doom. Because most people don't understand these concepts. And what we do is we lay it out in a manner that's easily understood. Because most people don't get it. Because again, no, there's no value in teaching this to you. That's why in your high school curriculum, you don't really learn as far as how things really work. They don't want you to know. The reason why they took away civics is they don't want you to know that government is we the people. They want you to think that government is government, those bad people. No, if you still had civics, you would know government is we the people. And if government isn't working right, we the people put people in there that will make sure and ensure that it works right. We have to get it right, people. We have to start understanding it is our responsibility. It is our responsibility to understand what is going on in this place. And we don't. The reality is we don't, but we must. If we don't do that, then they will continue the pilfer. And it is our responsibility. It is on us to teach ourselves.